Right, well, as I said, the US's biggest gift is that it is importing a lot less than it used to, not just this year, not this year before, but all going all the way back to 2009. US imports have been declining, US oil imports have been declining since 2009, and now it has reached a point where, courtesy of domestic production, the cut in those imports is so substantial that it has had a bearing on the supply side. And the entire market is feeling its effects. U.S. production peaked at one point in time in history, or what people thought that it had peaked. But then, courtesy shale, it's now back to very healthy production levels, and people expect it to stay at some of these production levels, somewhere around the region of 8 million barrels per day to 10 million barrels per day, and till quite possibly our 2030. So that's how far we're looking into. And if you look at Russia, you look at Saudi Arabia, they are the other two major producers, and they're all sort of churning out between 8 to 10 million barrels per day. And the US is almost neck and neck. By some accounts, and this is yet to be verified by the EIA, the US could become, at some point in time next year, could become the world's largest producer of oil for a period of time. You see, you have to understand about the shale revolution is that some of these shale wells, their life is not as long as some of the conventional oil wells. So in order to maintain these shale oil production, you'll have to constantly dig around the prospection site, because the life of these shale wells is shorter.
Could the USA punish Russia by releasing oil from the strategic petroleum reserve to lower oil prices?
It's a yes-no answer. The way I see it is, there is neither any need for it, nor does the macroeconomics justify. Because if the US were to release the strategic petroleum reserves, the SPR would trigger a complete plummeting of the oil price. I doubt that the conditions that we're seeing at the moment necessitate that.
Isn't there some relationship between oil prices and available reserves? If so, what is the logic?
Well, the logic is that we have had peak oil theorists sort of feed us with the logic that it's a finite commodity and it's running out. And I accept that argument. It is a finite commodity and it is running out. But I don't believe in peak oil, for the simple reason that we will find alternatives. If you go back to the 17th century and the 18th century, people predicted peak coal. Peak coal never materialized. There's so much coal out there that can power the planet for 100 years. It's just that coal is no longer cool. It is no longer considered the medium of choice, purely to do with carbon footprint. So there is a lot of coal out there, and peak coal never happened. I have a gut feeling that we will reach a point in time whereby which there will be substantial lowering of consumption, and that will kick in. You know, we talked about electric cars, we talked about fuel efficient engines. That's why I think the planet will look for alternatives and ultimately find a hydrocarbon alternative to oil, which de facto replaced coal as a fuel of choice.
How much would oil demand in the USA have to fall to have an impact on oil prices?
That's a difficult one, because oil demand in the US has peaks and troughs. So what I would say is, for the oil price to completely tank, if over the next 6 to 8 months, I don't see this happening, by the way, the next 6 to 8 months, if you go around by something like consumption in the States falls by about 25%, then you will have the short sellers will be all over the oil price. That is guaranteed. But I don't see that happening. I think U.S. demand, in a strict sense of the word, is falling, but at that lower level, it is also flattening out. It's not materially better. It's not materially worse. It's just that the demand is very stunted.